You need me?
That is some weird, wild stuff. That is funny. I did not know that.
Dropping drawers and stabbing whores on the Kevin Holly Show.
And I gotta say, he has balls. This man has balls. He's laying them out there for us to see.
That's a little something like our first date kit.
Ever shared a lustful evening with a Muslim woman?
We're dropping drawers and stabbing whores. It's the Kevin Holly Show.
This radio person is the whole problem. Are we going to allow this guy to be heard by anyone who can turn a dial?
I've got a pirate radio station. Nobody knows who he is.
You out there? You listening?
Scratch that itch and slap that bitch. Welcome to the Kevin Holly Show.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Kevin Holly Show. It is May 25th, 2016. This is episode 40. Over the hill with the show now.
Holy crap.
What the crap is that,
crikey,
man?
Mate. We're what crikey, mate. We're already
God,
up.
You said crap.
Crikey, we're up to 40. This is amazing, mates. I mean, I got to tell you.
Yeah, I mean, a good day, everybody. Last week, a baby, a dingo ate my baby. Hey, so who's in front of me? Mr. Jaybird. Welcome to the show, buddy. How
Thank
you doing?
Thank you, brother. Thank you. Glad to be here.
Well, it's always good to have you.
And I love being at the Dump Towers.
Oh, the Dump Towers is the shit. It is. The Dump Towers live in studio. Yeah, I should have said crap. I'm sorry. There's probably children listening knowing that Camden Pugh's in the house. Oh, hey, Camden Pugh's in the house. What's
hey,
up, Camden?
Mudcat.
How's it going?
Sitting in for homeless Chuck. Can we call him homeless Camden?
Okay, I've been sitting in for a homeless Chuck for about 2 months now.
Yeah, I think if Chuck comes back, he might be sitting in for a Mudcat, dude.
You might be right, man. Well, who's always sitting? That'd be Mr. Pops. What's up, Mr. Nall, my friend?
That
How
was
you doing?
A low blow, Kevin.
Well, you're a low blow? Why? Because he's in a wheelchair? Really?
Dude, that was a sensitive
No, well, that's because he hasn't missed but one show. He's always sitting in.
That was fucked up, Kevin.
That's not how I meant to, Camden, but whatever. Pops, how you doing, buddy?
I'm sitting here fine.
That's not what I meant. All right, you know what?
Anybody in the chat room already?
Don't worry, Pops. Hey, listen, man, you're a stand-up guy, and I would roll with you anytime, so.
one of the nicest compliments I ever had was a real nice chick one time. She said I was the kind of guy that she liked to be in an airplane wreck with. Think about that a bit.
Jay's always talking about being in a wreck. In a wreck? A wreck how do you say that?
In the erection.
Oh, man.
Airplane wreck had nothing to do with any erection.
Oh.
Although I did go in a bar one day and told the barmaid that I had a good day. I had 20 erections that day. She looked at me like, you're full of shit. I said, oh, no, I did. Ah, come on. I said, yeah, no. There was 10 by 10s, 5 15 by 15s, and 5 20 by 20s. That's 20 erections. She realized I was talking about my tents. She says, I thought, My boyfriend's pretty good, but he never came close to 20 erections in a day.
That's pretty intense, Pops.
Ooh, see what I did there? Nice comeback. Hey, come nice back. Comeback that on that comeback. One.
That's what comes after 15 years in the rental business. You do, you get a little wobbly.
So, Pops, I just wanted to ask, what kind of Gatorade is that you're drinking? I noticed that...
It's awfully thick.
Yeah, I've never seen a Gatorade like that before.
It says lemon lime on the package there, but it's red.
it's the color of... Bush beer and V8 juice.
Oh,
Bush
okay.
beer and
poor man's
juice.
Poor man's Bloody Mary.
Sounds delicious, man.
It is.
We should market that.
And yeah, I agree. Yeah.
If it's cheaper than X-Lax and Malcolm Magnesia, and it works better for me than either one of those.
Yeah, there you go. You probably taste better, too.
Blue ribbon.
And to add to the proof, one day when Jay was picking up a 12-pack of beer for me, he says, "You drink that?" And he says, "It gives me the shits." Jay says, "Oh, that's what my dad says. That's why I'm buying it.
That's why he's buying it, right?" All right, well, listen, everybody, just to throw this out there real quick, the hotline tonight to take live calls, if you want to call on the show, 727-237-6010. That's 727-237-6010. Also, hit us up on Twitter at KevinHollyShow4. That's the number 4. We also have a chat room. If you go on mixlr.com, well, you probably wouldn't know unless you're on there already, chat us up. We're always interacting with everybody. Welcome, Glick. Welcome, VerbalCon. Oh, man, look at that. VerbalCon's in the house tonight.
Dude, he flat out scares me.
He scares you? He's a scary dude, man.
Yeah, he creeps me out.
He creeps you out? Did he look at your package or what?
Well, I don't know. I don't want to say that. I mean, because it's
pretty
not
sure
really out there on the internet. But,
I'm pretty sure I saw him looking at your package, man.
All right, could be. Could
That's what
be.
He does. It's all right, though. It's cool, you know.
I'm scared.
We should probably pull that chat room up right now so we can all take a peek at it. Again, I want to remind everybody that we are having a special call-in guest tonight at 9:15 Eastern Standard Time, Miss Julie Ann Ream from Unsolved Mysteries, and she's quite the cowgirl. She's going to plug some of the things that she's been working with. She's written some books. She produces some award shows. And, of course, you know, I would love to pick her brain about Unsolved Mysteries. She was an investigative agent on that show for 10 years. Excuse me. How many people...
I'll ask her some questions about John Wayne.
There you go. I don't know about you guys, but I watched Unsolved Mysteries all the time when I was a kid, and it scared the crap out of me.
I watched John Wayne when I was a kid.
Yeah, yeah.
He solved mysteries. He didn't leave a single one unsolved.
I don't know. Maybe you have to look that up there, Mudcat. But either way, we'll be talking to her. That's a good question to ask her. Was there any mysteries that went unsolved? Or were they all solved?
Why the show's called Unsolved Mysteries.
I suppose, but did they eventually solve them, maybe?
Well, they solved a bunch of
them. They solved a bunch of them. That's good in
That's
my book.
That's what I was saying last time when this woman was supposed to call in, right? And which wasn't her fault. But I said, man, she must be real lousy at her job if all the mysteries are still unsolved.
Yeah, what is the mystery? I don't know, man. We'll figure it all out, though. It's going to be pretty cool. I can't wait to talk to her, so... Excuse me, I got a frog in my throat tonight, man. Anyway.
Yeah, how did it get there, dude? How did a frog just happen in your throat?
It happens, man. Frogs
While you're cleaning your frog. Camden, I think that they took these mysteries over when they had been unsolved for like 10 years. In other words, it wasn't right. like they were mysteries that had just happened. So they got them when the... a lot of the facts had changed and a lot of the evidence was missing, and right. they dug into them, and they created what happened, you know, and showed people on the program what happened, and then asked for any new information, and then they took the new information and went around, and they did find a lot of the perpetrators that had committed these mysteries that had been unsolved for quite a while. But that's my recollection, and my age has a way of catching up with me, so you may want to ask her if I'm telling you the truth.
All right, we'll definitely ask her.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, Kevin.
Yeah, yes.
I know that you have a car.
Right. I have a car, several
cars, right?
Oh, I'm loaded with the cars. I'm like, it's crazy at my house, man. There's deals left and right.
Well, I mean, you got more than one car, or do you just have one car?
He's got an Exploder.
I have one registered, beautiful SUV, and my fiance, Lori B, has a nice pickup truck. And then I also have a project car in my garage.
Do you just really love any of those vehicles?
To an extent, Camden, I do. I have had my Exploder long enough.
Would you
to
be
fall in
buried
with
one of your vehicles?
No, if I had maybe one of my older vehicles back, like the old 73 Stingray, if I would have been smart and not bought a house when I sold it and just kept that, I would be buried in that, sure.
Well, the reason I ask is because in this day, May 25th, but in 1994, a 71-year-old named George Swanson...
guilty.
By his request, obviously, he was cremated, and then his ashes were buried in his 1984 white Corvette.
A 1984? That's a crossfire injection junk-ass Corvette.
That's a horrible year to get buried.
He loved it, man. It was his beloved.
Was he a mechanic?
No, he was a beer distributor and ex-military from World War II.
All right, well, no one to rag on a World War II veteran, but cool. A 1984 Corvette?
The worst year they ever made.
He loved it.
My dad had one. He ended up giving it to my brother, and nothing but problems, man. Constant problems with that car. And it was, like, one of the slowest, least amount of horsepower models they ever made. It had, like, 240
horsepower. But come on, dude, he clearly loved it.
That's cool. I mean, yeah, people love their Geos, you know.
Yeah, people love their Ford Rangers.
I'd get buried in my protege, but Tyler'd probably be like, hell no, I'm selling that, man.
Yeah,
frickin'.
Tyler would want to flip it.
Yeah, homeless Chuck would want to live in it.
He'd be like, cremate him, dude. Freaking, I'm keeping the protege, you know.
Yeah. Have you changed the emblems on that to say protege?
No, I'm working on that.
We'll do that tonight, man.
All right.
Protege.
The Mazda protege. I love
that.
Yeah.
I had a 49 Chevy once I was almost buried in.
He's not lying.
Getting a wreck in it?
Tyler's got the picture.
He got a wreck in it?
I was coming home from a drunken engagement. And I
not
went,
that we encourage
I went,
drunken
I went,
driving on
I
this
went
show.
Into yeah. Into a field, and it took about a 2-foot drop, and the front wheels dug in, and they went ass over appetite 3 times. Fortunately, me and the guy who was with me, I think he was driving, but I wouldn't be able to prove it. But we flew out on each side of the car, and the car just kept going. We ended up in a mud puddle, and I woke up 3 days later in the hospital wondering what the hell I was doing there. But
so what year was that?
1956.
So what kind of penalty in 1956 did you get for a DUI?
I didn't get a DUI.
No, but if you did get a DUI, what would be the punishment?
Oh, I got one a few weeks later, probably after that.
Oh my God!
And that was
died in 1956 by flipping a car, driving drunk, and you didn't get a DUI. So you tried it again two weeks later.
I almost died a couple of times a few years before that.
All right. So what
it's
kind
a
of
very wild time in
what
pop
kind of,
life?
What kind of penalties did you get for a DUI?
For the DUI?
Yeah, in 56.
I had a real pissed off mother. I spent a night in jail. I had a real pissed off mother. I remember she said to me when I got out in the car, she came and she had, I think it was a $250
bail,
yeah, and she had $200 cash, and she was going to write him a check for $50, and they wouldn't take her check. My mother never wrote a bum check in her life. But anyhow, she was so pissed off because she had to go and get cash money. And anyhow, she came and bailed me out.
Well, where do you go for cash money when you have a check in 1956? You go down to the general store and hit up the clerk.
She went to the bank and she had her money.
That's awesome.
All right, so, I mean, did you get probation? Did you have DUI classes? What'd you have?
Yeah, I had my, I went to a DUI class, yeah.
Really? Back in 1956, they had, did they show you, like, old videos of people? What I mean, what was a DUI class like in 56?
I don't remember, man. I don't even
All
remember.
Right.
I don't even
I don't
remember.
Think you had
I don't
a DUI
even
class.
Remember. I don't even remember the one through in 1970. that's enough of that baloney. Let's talk something interesting.
Baloney. Hey, no, also,
that was very interesting to me, actually. I mean, because...
Hey, also today, this is pretty cool. Babe Ruth today in 1935.